Hello guys, we are back with our next tutorial. In this tutorial, we will be going through Haskell. So this is one of the most similar programming language to ML, guys. All the concepts are exactly similar to that. Exactly similar to that. So now let us go through it. So similarly to ML syntax, statical scope, strong type, and type interfacing, everything is available in Haskell also. So the main difference from ML and most other languages is that it is a purely functional, guys, this language. So it has no variable, no assignment statements. Okay, so that is one of the problem in this basically, but they say that this is an advantage. So let us take an example of a small program. So let us assume FIB, that is nothing but Fibonacci of 0 equal to 1, Fibonacci of 1 equal to 1, Fibonacci of n plus 2 is equals to Fibonacci of n plus 1 plus Fibonacci of 2. So you'll be getting the results of Fibonacci 0, 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8, 9, 10. You can substitute the values and you can get. So if you substitute the value of initially it is 0, then it is 1, then it is 2, then it will be 3, I think so, then it will be 5, then it will be 8, like that. This is the Fibonacci order, guys. So that should be the result of this program. So now I hope everyone got a small idea on Haskell. Basically repeat the concepts of same of ML, guys. That's nothing but Haskell. The same concept with same syntaxes are in Haskell also. So now I hope everyone got a small idea on this. So in the next tutorial, we'll be going through applications of functional programming language. Thank you. Thanks for watching.